Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. Here's what you need to know as we begin this Monday, November 2nd. New Jersey residents and businesses are bracing for another round of COVID restrictions. As Governor Murphy says, all options are on the table as we are in the midst of a second wave. The number of positive tests of coronavirus continue to increase, as do the number of hospitalizations and the number of critical patients. And while Governor Murphy says he does believe that this recent spike is tied to private gatherings, he still has the possibility of business closings, a statewide curfew, and new stay-at-home orders in his pocket to help control the spread. Inviting parents inside for a visit, a play date for your kids, an outdoor party. Health officials are all citing those as an example of gatherings that can lead to an increase in the number of COVID cases. Some health officials and government officials say we are getting careless, fatigued by COVID, but the virus is not getting fatigued. There is no doubt that online learning has been stressful for many of our kids. Seventh grader Ailey Smith captured just how stressful it is for her in a letter to the East Windsor School Superintendent. NJ.com published the letter. She wrote, "My anxiety and stress have been off the charts since school started." As she details how she logs into class at 8 a.m., doesn't leave her computer until almost 3, she pleads for school officials and the superintendent in particular to allow at least some in-person learning. On Facebook, the school superintendent said, "This is the best way for in-person learning in the midst of this pandemic to continue to teach online." New York is giving up that travel advisory list that we had with New Jersey, Connecticut, and New York in a consortium. They're simply saying now that anybody who arrives has to test negative when they arrive and before they leave. New Jersey continues to adhere to that quarantine list. 45 states now reach the threshold. President Trump and Joe Biden are making their closing arguments to the American people ahead of Election Day tomorrow. With the general election coming up, the Office of Homeland Security in New Jersey is preparing to respond to any issues. The head of Homeland Security in the Garden State says all of their officers are on high alert heading into Election Day. The counting of ballots already underway in many counties in New Jersey. There are some National Guards men and women who have been assigned to verify signatures and to help with that counting. More than 3 million mail-in ballots have already been received. New Jersey's embrace of early voting is not likely to go away after this election. In fact, many are predicting that it'll be with us for a long time, and there will be additional changes with electronic voting machines for the next election. Join me tomorrow night, election night, starting at 7. We have full election coverage on New Jersey 101.5, on air, online at nj1015.com, and on our free mobile app. Another sign of concerns about possible unrest following the election, businesses in Atlantic City have been boarding up doors and windows, most visibly the Tanger outlets in Atlantic City. The mayor calls it unfortunate, but understands why people would want to protect their businesses. And the MVC has begun offering appointments online, not for everything and not at every location, but if you go to the MVC website, they'll be able to guide you as to whether or not you can make an online appointment or if you still have to go and make an appointment in person or stand online. Got something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Don't forget to like and share this video. And we're always talking Jersey, taking your calls on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's what you need to know for this Monday, November 2nd. Have a great day.